Greetings, Earthlings. Aunt Duddie here. I'm in my backyard looking at my overgrown, weedy little flower pots, watching a bee I'm allergic to flitting around to the chives. And I just wanted to give you a little update on my broken arm, wrist, thumb, and hand. Still broken, but I'm making progress. I can lift my arm up. Not all the way, but I can lift it up. Dr. M said, if I don't get that shoulder moving, she's going to force me to go to a physical terrorist. Ooh, I've already experienced the hand physical terrorist and other body part physical terrorists, but that shoulder scares me. So anyway, today I'm doing laundry. I have to take it easy because my blood pressure is like 88 billion over a jillion. So I'm on R&R and new BP meds and phone. Hold on. Oh, that was little mama on the phone. She and the kids are coming over tomorrow to help me do stuff, which I'll tell you about in a different video. So what was I telling you? I'm just like doing laundry today and having high blood pressure. I'm on 2 days of R&R. Today's the second day. So instead of my usual, you know, the Hooters or the Whalers or the, you know, golden moldy oldies, I'm listening to Strauss waltzes. I think they can help lower your blood pressure. I don't know. Anyway, so here's what's going on. We're moving. We found a place. It isn't exactly what we were looking for. Crowbert, get out of my video! Pain in the butt. I won't miss him. Yes, we were looking for another townhome about half the size of this monstrosity. And we did find one, and we put a deposit on it, but then we backed out of it. And it was just too far of a commute for Hungry Hubby. He has to drive to Seattle and back twice a day. And he already commutes 45 minutes, and the new townhome would have put us over an hour each way. And I just don't like him on the road that much. I mean, he gets clobbered by drunk drivers because of his shift work, you know. And, yeah, we've had some rough times when he's been, you know, knocked out of commission by somebody skidding in ice or skidding in rain. So the less he has to drive, the better. This way he's about 5 minutes closer. I know it doesn't sound like a lot, but 5 minutes closer. We don't have to really leave our neighborhood. We're only a few miles, maybe 5 miles away from this house. And it's more of an adult-type community. We won't have any gangbangers. You know, people sitting on their cars selling dope in the parking lot. And we won't have to live next door to Smokey. Ugh. Anyways, so that's what's going on with us. And we'll probably move in the beginning of July, between mid-June and July, depending on how health problems settle down. We really, you know, don't have to leave our monstrosity townhome until probably the end of July, but, you know, we don't want to move in the middle of all that. So, I can't wait to show you the new place. It's so tiny compared to this. It'll be easier for me. We can get rid of so much junk. That's why my little mom and niece is coming over. She's going to help me get rid of all my basement junk. I have so much stuff in that basement, and I haven't even been down there for like a year. So, we'll see what happens. Anyway, I'm hoping that I do feel better because I'm looking forward to this move. We're moving amidst all the waterfowl, a beautiful duck pond with geese in it too, and overlooking the lake. So it'll be a pretty view. It's a kind of a condo situation, but it's more like a flat than two stories. Although we got the top floor, which is the best view, it'll be hard on my kneecaps, but I gotta move around somewhat. So that's what's going on. Friday is the big drawing for the Aunt Duddie's 500 subscriber VR contest thingy. I hope some more people enter because I've got like 10, and I picked up my cheesy little prize yesterday after I came back from Dr. M's. And it's cute, and it's something that I've given as gifts before, and everyone loves them. And then I have another little surprise. So anyway, I'm not going to miss things around here at all. Well, I won't be able to see the mountain, but that lake view makes up for it. If I stand on top of the roof, I can see the mountain, but I don't know. My little mama niece, she has a big, huge view of the mountain, and we'll go to her farm someday and take pictures of it. What a nice, clear day. So anyway, that's what's going on in my life. Having some physical problems. I sure wish I could get, you know, a lot more help to help me go through the embarrassment of throwing away my junk. And I have a lot of junk. And get my packing done without too much stress. And that's what I'm going to do anyway. Little mom and niece will go and get me some boxes and some more Sharpies and masking tape. And, the new place has a garage. Guess what? The car's not going in there. I need a place for all my preps. So that's going to be my prep room. And Hungry can put his junk in there, too. But it's just a little one-car garage, but it's perfect for a freezer, an extra refrigerator, all my racks, my, let's see, what do I have, 5 canners now? I don't know. I have a lot of canners, but little mama niece is, you know, she's a canner, too, but she only has one short hot water bath canner. So I'm going to give her a couple of mine so she can a lot more. She's working on baby number 4, so she needs a can a lot. I usually try to think of her when I am canning things, so they have extra jam and jelly. Well, you know, Sweet Pea is her oldest kid. Sweet Pea, they ran out of jam because little mama niece makes jam. And so I had given them some grape jelly I made. So they served it for breakfast one day, and Sweet Pea was trying to spread it on her toast, and it kept rolling this way and rolling that way. Oh, she said, "What's wrong with this jam, Mama?" And her mama said, "Well, that's jelly. Aunt Duddie made it." And she's pushing it around on her toast, and she goes, "I thought Aunt Duddie could cook better than this." Out of the mouths of babes. Okay, so anyway, got stuff on the line. I'll miss my clothesline. Maybe not. Yeah, stuff on the line, stuff in the washer, stuff in the dryer. But it's a take-it-easy kind of day. Anyway, I hope you all enter my little video response contest on my 500 subs. Because when somebody wins that cheesy little gift, they're going to go, "Ooh!" And you won't be able to because it won't be yours if you don't enter and win. Okay. Love you guys. Bye.